You might think, a welder from just a spark plug? Really? But this tiny thing sparks a whole chain of experiments. Today, we continue the journey turning something simple into a working welder. Let's get started. Before we dive into building the welder, I'm going to take a little time to clean this spark plug thoroughly. It's a small piece, but if it's not clean, it could affect the whole process. Using a bit of multipurpose oil will get the spark plug clean quickly, without taking up too much time. It's a simple but effective trick, especially if you want to jump straight into building the welder without getting held up here. Bear with me here, I've muted the audio for this part because of some background noise. So the spark plug is all cleaned up. Now, I'm going to flip it over and screw the threaded part into the drill, getting ready for the next step. Next, I've got a positive electrical plug. We're going to use one of its prongs as the welding tip for this homemade welder. I know you might be wondering how this plug prong can actually work as a welding tip. But don't overthink it, everything will make more sense as we move on. After narrowing down the spark plug's threaded end, I was able to secure the plug prong much more easily. Once it's securely fixed, I'm going to sharpen the plug prong so it resembles a proper welding tip. So we've finished shaping the plug prong into a welding tip. Now we'll move on to the next step, connecting the electrical wires. We'll connect one end of this wire to the connector so the heat can transfer directly through it to the welding tip. The other end we'll deal with later in the next step. If we leave the wire dangling like this, it'll get in the way while welding, and if the connection isn't strong, the wire could eventually snap. So, I'm going to wrap a few layers of tape to secure and protect the joint. Here I've got a piece of PVC pipe. We're going to use it as a handle, making it safer and easier to hold our homemade welder. To make it more secure, I'm going to wrap tape around the spark plug until it's firmly fixed to the PVC pipe. As long as it's snug, we're good. For the other end of the wire, I'm going to attach an alligator clip. This will later connect to the positive terminal of the battery. To make the device work properly, we need a wire connected to the negative terminal of the battery, with alligator clips attached to both ends. Here, I'm using a small battery with the right specifications to keep this device running smoothly. Be careful when connecting the wires, making sure everything is secure to avoid any mishaps. Alright, let's start the test. Let's see how everything performs. From my assessment after the first small test, I noticed the heat is very focused on a single point, which makes the welding process much more efficient. Coming up, I'll do two more small examples and I won't say anything so you can form your own perspective on this welder. Drop your thoughts in the comments, I'm curious to hear what you think. How did you feel about the two examples just now? I hope it gave you a clearer perspective on how this welder works, from the smallest details to the overall setup. Doing these DIY experiments not only helps you understand the technical side better, but also gives a really fun hands-on experience. If you found this video useful, don't forget to hit like and subscribe so you can follow along with the next experiments, where I'll try even more ideas and improvements on the device.